Hi, my name is Thibault, analytics translator at DataRoots in Leuven. Just as with all of you, Corona had a large impact on the lives of everybody here at DataRoots. We were then also intrigued when we read in the news that a large part of the positive COVID tests might actually be false positives. Were all the drastic measures taken based on false statistics? Well, let's first have a look at what a false positive test outcome means. False positive means that your test result says you're infected, but in reality, you're not. When performing any COVID test, you have only two possible outcomes. Either you're infected or either you're not. But how is this decided? Well, the test procedure goes as follows. The stick that went into your nose is put into a machine where it is twisted around. After every twist, they check if a certain chemical reaction took place. The amount of twists needed for this reaction to take place is referred to as the CT value or cyclic threshold. The lower this value, the faster it is detected and the higher the probability you're infected. That's right, probability. No test gives a 100% certain outcome. People with a CT value of 1 might not be infected at all, while infected people might pass the test without any reaction taking place. In Belgium, the threshold is put at a CT value of 40. Everybody below is considered infected, the others are not. However, unavoidably, unregarding of which threshold value is chosen, you will always have some wrongly classified cases. Some infected people will be classified as non-infected. These are called false negatives. On the other hand, you will also have some healthy people who will be classified as infected, the so-called false positives. The people with their actual health situation corresponds with the outcome of the tests are called true positives and true negatives. No test is perfect, but depending on what you're testing, you might prefer one mistake over the other. For example, when having teenagers pass their driving license, you want to make sure that everybody who you give a driving license can also actually drive. You rather have them retake the exam than handing out the license to a bad driver. You thus prefer false negatives over false positives. Or you might prefer false positives over false negatives. Like when detecting cancer, because the last thing you want is a patient with cancer leaving their doctor's office thinking he or she is still healthy. So, how does this link back to Corona? Recent studies have shown that people having a CT value higher than 35, so being labeled as infected, actually very often contain dead virus particles from months ago and are thus possibly at no risk for themselves or their environment. Some hospitals reported the amount of positive cases having a CT value of 35 or higher to represent up to 40% of all positive cases. Does this mean that 40% of all positive cases is wrong? Certainly not. It only means that 40% of the positive tests have a lower probability of being infected than the black and white test result indicates. Some of them will be infected while others won't. That's why some virologists suggested to mention the CT value on the test outcomes instead of a positive or negative label. This might actually not be such a bad idea. Just as with every classification model we produce here at DataRoots or every model produced anywhere else in the world, you're never 100% sure about the real value. You can only tell how probable your outcome is. Depending on how sure you want to be about either the negative or either the positive cases, you adjust the threshold to get either more false positives or more false negatives. While more false positives will result in fewer deaths in this case, the stricter measures coming with it also had their drawbacks. That's why it's important to have a discussion with all stakeholders, both virologists and economists. The same holds for machine learning models. You still need people to correctly interpret the outcome of the model. Just as measures might have been taken too quick or not quick enough based on the Corona test results, taking similar measures for your company purely based on the black and white outcome of model might limit you in achieving maximal return on investment. Just as the perfect set of measures for Corona would protect the full population while still sustaining economic development, the correct interpretation of your next machine learning model will maximize your return on investment. So, I hope you learned something from this talk. I will manage your company the way you would like the government to handle this Corona crisis.